love this.
Yeah, me too. If we go to Jack Ryan, let's get some of this.
Come on, baby. The new Nash Country, Bernie and Sid in the morning. Let's sing along to this.
There's a new wind blowing like a river. I'm breathing.
So a couple of weeks ago, my buddy Mike Sullivan, Brennan and Carr in Brooklyn, who's in Vegas right now. His son is in the rugby championship. Says, listen, you got to get Jack Ryan on the show. Everybody loves Jack Ryan, Channel 11, Channel 9, from Rucker Park to Marine Park to West 4th Street, and an eventual tryout with Bill Fitch on the New Jersey Nets. Black Jack Ryan is a legitimate New York City legend. Same courts where guys like Connie Hawkins, Luol Cinder, Tiny Archibald, Lamar Odom, all those guys became big stars. So did Jack Ryan. So big, mind you, that Netflix started streaming just this morning, titled Losers, and Ryan's got his own episode titled Blackjack, story about New York City legend Jackie Ryan. With that said, making his second visit to the program, a New York legend, and a guy that's not afraid to scoff down a couple of cheese beefs any given Monday at Brennan and Carr.
Yeah.
Our good buddy Jack Ryan. Good morning, Jack.
Hello, Jack. Good morning, guys. Thanks for having me on.
Well, congratulations.
Yes, congratulations. Big time. Blackjack Ryan. Hey, listen, why do they call this thing Losers? I mean, that you're far from a loser.
Well, you know, I'm looking at it right now on my phone, and it says, in the winning is everything society. How do we handle failure? You know, so it's about these athletes who have turned the agony of defeat into human triumph.
Ah, and listen, you've done that for people who didn't hear you here last time, and this isn't a very big sports audience. They may not know your story, Jack, but you're a guy, again, that was you were a great basketball player. You still are, by all accounts, but so good that you were worthy of playing in the pros, but you had some trials and tribulations and some injuries, never realized all that potential. Tell the listeners quickly exactly what happened in your story.
Well, I was a kid that grew up, you know, like a lot of kids, you know, couldn't listen to the authority, wanted to do it my way. I was a parent's worst nightmare, teacher's worst nightmare, coach's worst nightmare. I had the talent, but I didn't do everything that I needed to do.
And you grew up in Brooklyn or Queens? I forget.
Brooklyn, right. Windsor Terrace, Brooklyn. So I had the talent, but I, you know, there's certain things you got to do. You got to be a good student. You got to get the grades. You got to listen to your coaches. You got to stay in the system, listen, you know, play in the coach's system. And if I would have did that, according to Rick Carlisle in Netflix, if I would have did that, then I would have played in the NBA, according to him, and according to Peter Vesey also.
By the way, Rick Carlisle is currently the head coach of the Dallas Mavericks, and he's won two NBA championships as coach of that team.
Yes, that's him.
And Chris Mullin once described Jack as the best shooter he'd ever seen who hadn't played in the NBA. I mean, you got some skills, my brother.
Well, you know, it's all I did when I was growing up. I got in trouble doing everything else. The only time I knew I was doing something right is when I was playing ball at East Fifth Street Park in Brooklyn. That's the only time. Well, so when I did fail at not having a good game or something, I would lose my mind because I put so much work into that. And
yeah.
I always had that heart, like I'm going to go out there and kill these guys because I know I practice more than anybody.
Yes. Chris Mullin and all his brothers used to play every day at Marine Park in Brooklyn. That's where I spent 20-plus years playing ball almost every single day. And, you know, I know all the parks in and around Brooklyn, Manhattan, the Bronx, Rucker, East 5th, which you said you played at. But I think when you're a schoolyard legend, a ballpark legend, the ultimate, the Harvard, if you will, the best education is West 4th. When you graduate to that court and you can go there and actually play well, then you've really made it as a legendary New York ball player, and you did that.
I believe so. I believe so, you know, especially back in the 80s. That was the place to go. You know, I heard about it for years, West 4th, and when I was killing everybody in Brooklyn, and I said to myself, let me see how good I really am. So I rode my bike all the way to West 4th, and I made an impact the first day I was there, and that's it. That's my home. That's my family. I still go there to play, even if I'm not at his home. It's my backyard.
Jack Ryan said he bullshizzled with all his friends, but we had to dump that little portion because you can't say the actual thing. But anyway, Jack Ryan, listen, you also played, you were this close to getting into the NBA. You're a Guinness World Record holder for shooting or whatever it is, and you played for the Harlem Wizards as well. I mean, you've had a pretty successful career nonetheless.
Well, yeah, lucky me, Todd Davis from the Harlem Wizards, when he heard about me, took a chance and said yes. I mean, what if he would have said no?
Right.
I wouldn't be on the phone with you guys right now. I mean, he gave me the opportunity, and when I became a Harlem Wizard, I said, I prepared for this my whole life. I was a clown. I got thrown out of every classroom. I was always a good basketball player, and I started spinning basketballs when I was 8 or 9 years old. So I embraced this, and I said, I'm not screwing this up like I screwed everything else up in my life. And, you know, I worked at it, you know, with the basketball tricks, just like when I was a little kid trying to be a good basketball player. It was morning, noon, night. In the parks, in the gyms, in my apartment, spinning basketballs and doing, you know, all the basketball tricks. And I got good at it from practicing so much.
You know, it is kind of surreal, though, I got to think for you. When, you know, you got this legendary story and playing in schoolyards and eventually getting a tryout for the Nets. And like Bernie just pointed out, playing for the Harlem Wizards and people around town, no matter where Jack goes, folks, Brooklyn, Queens, Staten Island, out in Jersey, they know who he is. But I got to imagine that at 3 o'clock this morning, when Netflix starts to run this series, Jack, and there's an episode dedicated to you, Blackjack is the title, that's got to be surreal, no, brother?
Well, you know, growing up, if you would have said, Jack, you're going to have all this, you're going to be in magazines as one of the greatest streetball players of all time, and you're going to have a documentary done, then another one done on Netflix, I would have said, no way. You know, I was just doing it when I was a kid. Because it was my love. It's all I wanted to do. I loved it. I knew I was good at it. I liked the praise. I loved the oohs and the ahs. And, yeah, I didn't know it was going to turn out like this. I did it for the love.
Now, on the way out, for people that don't know this, Jack was in studio with me and Bernie a couple of weeks ago. He was spinning basketballs on Bernie's head and my head and Jill's head. And he does all this fun stuff. And I don't know if people know this, but Jack is actually hired all the time by folks throwing bar mitzvahs, having parties, because Jack comes, does all of his basketball tricks, and kind of mingles with the crowd. And that's one of your work things, right, Jack? You actually go to different parties and put on a show with the basketballs and all that good stuff.
Oh, yeah. I do, birthday parties, bar mitzvahs, summer camps, you name it. I have a whole interactive comedy basketball show. And it's a blast. Both the kids and the adults love it. You know, I get school assemblies. It's my favorite thing because I just sent Jill a picture of me with 400 kids and I'm sitting down spinning 5 basketballs. And if you zoom in on the kids' faces, almost every single one of them, their mouths are wide open. So that's my fuel. Nice. The kids are my fuel. I get to see the kids smile and hear the laughter of children every day.
You're a good guy, Jack. Right? Listen, how can people get in? By the way, we posted that on our Twitter page, but how can people get in touch with you?
My website, hoopwizard.com, HOOPWIZARD.com.
Well, listen, we're all going to watch this again coming up. It started streaming last night, Losers on Netflix. Jack's episode is Blackjack, and you've been on the show twice because we love you. You're a great guest, and your story is a great story, Jack. And congratulations on getting a Netflix series on. That's a great job, buddy. Thank you.
Thanks so much, Jill, Bernie, and Sid, and to my best friend in the world, Sully. I'll see you at Brendan's car, buddy.
All right, there he is. The great Jack Ryan. Nice. Check out the Netflix series Losers, and specifically the show that's titled Blackjack. 1-800-848-WABC. We'll take your phone calls, more topics to cover, and Jackie the Joke Man Martling still to come. Wrapping up on a Friday. Right after these words.
Losers. Bernie and Sid in the morning.